Hi everyone, this is ABCs of Anaesthesia and happy 2022. Now this episode comes thanks to a comment I got recently from a medical student, so from FH. Thanks so much for this comment, by the way, because it's definitely from your comments that I get ideas on how and what to do videos on. So this particular comment and essentially said, can you please do a similar video, but this time drawing the full cannula insertion process with all the specific steps, for example, advanced, then lower, etc. It's hard to wrap your head around it all and overwhelming as a medical student. Now I really resonate with this. As a medical student, even as a junior doctor, it was really hard to think about exactly what the cannula is doing inside the vein and, you know, just how to visualize that. So thanks very much, FH. Thanks very much for your comment. And that's what we're going to do to get started. I also want to thank Ali Abdul, fantastic YouTube channel, and just his advice on using notability and how to communicate that way on YouTube was pretty much the inspiration for me getting this and having a go at it myself. So apologies for the lack of drawing skills, but let's get started. In this video, I'm going to go through a drawing or a schematic representation of what the needle looks like as you're achieving cannulation in a vein. So we're going to go through seven steps. So these ones are firstly starting off at a shallow angle, then entering very slowly, getting the flashback of blood in the chamber, leveling out, advancing the needle and cannula together until you're in the right distance in the vein, then pushing off the plastic cannula and taking the needle out. So that's pretty much exactly what we're going to go through. Now note that we're not going to go through any of the preparation, setup, positioning, aseptic non-touch technique or ANTS. All of that's for another video. This is simply the needle and how it interacts with the vein. Now just a bit of a refresher, this is a 14 gauge needle, probably the best way I can really demonstrate, but there's essentially a few components. But the first thing to know is that you have a needle, a chamber, and the plastic cannula. So the needle is on the inside. The plastic cannula goes over the needle, and that's the thing that's left inside the vein. And then if you look over here, there is this plastic chamber. So the needle itself then feeds into this plastic chamber, and that's where you'll see the first flashback, as I call it. So the flashback of blood will appear in that chamber. Now this chamber, you can actually take off this cap, and that chamber you can see will fill up with blood and will actually drip out blood or liquid without this cap. And in a future video, I'll show you about one of the advantages of putting saline into that chamber instead of having air, but that's for another video as well. So that's what it looks like. If I take it apart, so you've got your safety needle there, and here is the plastic cannula. That's what stays in the vein. It is not sharp, and that way you can give drugs, fluids, whatever you need to, and it stays inside the vein. So I'm going to start by drawing a vein. So the first step is making sure that you have a shallow angle. For this, I'm just going to draw this one line here, and that's going to be your cannula. So imagine that. If you insert your cannula with a pretty steep angle, this is the distance that you'll be able to extend that cannula before you go through the other side of the vein, which is a problem. Now, if you have a really shallow angle, imagine that. So as you can see, when you enter at a shallow angle, this distance over here is far better because there's more distance that your needle has to travel before it goes to the other side of the vein versus this one here. It's a lot shallower versus the steep angle here. The distance that the needle can travel down through the vein is much shorter. Therefore, you have less room for error. So it's better to go at a shallow angle, but that's the first step. So the next thing I want to mention is that it is far better to go slowly, especially when you're starting. In my previous video, you noticed that I mentioned there's like 39 different steps to getting your cannulation absolutely right. So imagine you have a really small vein. Now, in a big vein, it probably doesn't matter too much how fast you go as long as your technique's pretty accurate, because as soon as that needle is in the vein, you'll experience a flashback of blood in the chamber. Now in small veins are a lot lower pressure, and the needle that you're going to be using is a very tiny needle. So that blood might take at least a second or so before it actually appears in the cannula chamber. So that's why I'd recommend for these really small veins that you just want to go really, really slowly and pausing, you know, for a little bit of time. This is definitely for advanced cannulas in very small veins using very small needles. And so that's why I always enter slowly. You just need time for that blood to appear in the cannulation chamber. Now you hear people talking about a flashback. So just to demonstrate again, flashback is what occurs when you get your needle into the vein and then you get blood flashing back into this chamber here. So that's what flashback is. So if I'm to just draw that needle and cannula structure, you'll see what I mean. So you've got a needle entering like this, and then you've got your cannula just across the outside of the needle. as soon as your needle is in the vessel, you'll have blood traverse up the needle and go into the chamber and collect there. And that's what flashback means. So imagine you enter the vein and you get flashback. If you don't sharpen your angle and you keep going straight down, you've only got this much distance before you hit the other side of the wall. Now, that's the reason why we shallow the angle. Imagine we get flashback as soon as we enter the vein wall. So now you've got a flashback of blood. If I'm then to change the angle and make it shallower, I enter the wall and then I've got far more distance to travel before I get a puncture on the deep side. So that's why we make the angle shallow and advance the needle at that point. You might hear me saying, the more you flatten that angle, the better it is. And there's a reason why. The IV cannula is designed in such a way that the top surface is not very good at cutting, but the bottom surface is very good at being cut. Now you might hear me talk about flattening that angle and flattening it quite severely. And the reason is this. So imagine that this is actually your vein. This needle is very good at cutting inside the vein and then very good at cutting below, just like that, as you can see. But it's very, very bad at cutting the top surface. Now I'm pulling up quite high there, and it's just very difficult to cut the top surface just the way this bevel tip is designed. So what that looks like in this diagram, once I've got flashback, I really shallow that angle. That way, there's very little chance of me cutting this bottom surface, and it's very unlikely that I'm going to cut this top surface. And just remember, there's only two ways that your cannula fails once you have flashback. First of all, you don't advance it far enough, or you advance it too far and it punctures another wall in the vein. Now the next question is, how far do you advance a cannula? And the answer is really, it depends on the size of the cannula. A 22 gauge cannula, like this one, the bevel is only about a millimeter or two. That means that you only have to advance it about, you know, 3 millimeters, maybe four, before you enter both the needle and the cannula into the vein, and therefore you can advance the cannula fully within the vein. But if you look in a big 14 gauge, the bevel itself is about 7 millimeters, and the cannula starts probably almost 9 millimeters. Therefore, once you have flashback, you probably need to advance at least a centimeter or so, even more, depending on how thick the vein wall is as well. So that's a 14 gauge. You have to advance it far more. So the way I think about it, if I've got a needle here, and I've got a cannula here, the distance I advance really depends on the distance of the bevel plus a little bit more to account for the cannula where it starts and the vein wall. So roughly bevel plus a couple of millimeters usually accounts for all of those things. But this is the distance that you need to advance. So imagine you've got the cannula in and you got flashback. Now you flatten out the angle so it's really flat and you advance that cannula in. So now the cannula looks a bit like this. You've got the needle in and you've got the cannula in. Now you're able to advance that cannula in through the vein without any problem. So you've pretty much got the flashback, you've advanced the distance, which is a bevel plus a little bit, and then you know you're in. You flatten out the angle so you've got very little chance of puncturing the deep surface of the vein. And you're almost aiming at that top surface of the vein just because that's very hard to cut the top surface. So now your needle's in the vein, your cannula is in the vein as well. Now you're able to advance that plastic cannula off. So again, what it looks like is you're pushing off the cannula with your pointer finger and that goes into the vein itself. And then you pull this needle out in that direction. So what you're now left with is a cannula inside the vein. And that way you can give your drugs and administer your drugs and your medications or whatever you need. So please forgive me for my terrible drawings, but that basically is everything that you need to know about advancing the cannula as it relates to the vein, just in a diagrammatic format. Hopefully that helped you understand exactly the mechanics of what's going inside, and I'll probably try and use these kind of templates in the future to try and demonstrate things like arterial lines and central venous line as well. So thanks very much for watching ABCs of Anaesthesia. I hope that helped. I suspect there'll be a lot of criticisms of my drawing, but that's completely fine. Hopefully I'll get better for the next one. And again, I'll see you in the next video. Thanks very much for watching.